Good morning, students. Let's learn today new lesson, mensuration. Okay. Now, in this lesson, first you are going to learn perimeter. Now, what is perimeter? Perimeter is a distance around a closed figure when we go around the figure once. Perimeter of polygon can be obtained simply by adding lengths of all the sides. Now see, if you want to find the perimeter of this figure, see now this figure is closed figure, so perimeter is the distance around a closed figure. Perimeter is the distance around a closed figure. Now suppose if we want to find the perimeter of this figure, what we are going to do? We are going to add its lengths. Okay, all the sides. See, this side plus this side plus this side means we are going to add all its sides. Okay, now perimeter of this figure. See, perimeter is equal to perimeter of this figure. I am going to find now. See, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EF plus FG plus GH plus HI plus IJ plus JK plus KL plus AL or LA. Okay, AL or LKL, LA also we can say. Okay, now see, AB, this distance is how much? It is given 1 centimeter. See, this distance is given in figure 1 centimeter. Okay, this is 1 centimeter. So 1 centimeter plus, now BC, BC how much it is given? 2 centimeter plus CD 1 centimeter plus DE 2 centimeter plus EF 2 centimeter plus FG 1 centimeter. Okay, plus GH 2 centimeter plus HI it is given. See, 2 centimeter. See, from here to here it is given 2 centimeter. From here to here 2 centimeter. Okay, 2 centimeter means this distance it is given 2 centimeter. From here to here also it is given 2 centimeter. See, it is there in your textbook. It is given 2 centimeter. Okay, so 2 centimeter plus IJ 1 centimeter plus, now JK how much it will come? 2 centimeter. See, it is given. See, from here to here it is 2 centimeter. Okay. So, KL, see, it is given 1 centimeter. So, KL 1 centimeter plus AL also 1 centimeter. Okay. So, now add its lengths. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 2, 11, 11 plus 2, 13, 13 plus 1, 14, 14 plus 2, 16, 16 plus 1, 17, 17 and 1, 18. So, 18 centimeters. So, what is the perimeter of this figure? 18 centimeter. Okay. Let's find now perimeter of rectangle. Now this, see, this given figure is rectangle. See, AB, BC, CD and AD. Okay, these four sides are there and this given figure is rectangle. Now we have to find the perimeter of rectangle. Now what is perimeter? Sum of the length of its sides. Okay, we are going to add this all the sides. So right here, perimeter of the rectangle. Perimeter of the rectangle, sum of the lengths of its all sides are four sides. Now, how many sides it has? Four sides. Okay, it's four sides. Okay, so sum of the length of its four sides. Now, first side is AB. Okay, so AB plus BC, BC plus CD, CD plus DA or AD. Okay, we can write DA or AD. So DA, C. Okay, so now if you will see AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Now AB plus BC. See now, AB plus BC. See, AB plus BC. AB, see here, AB plus BC. Plus CD. Now CD. CD and AB both are equal. CD and AB both are equal. See, both of them have. See, opposite sides of rectangle are equal. This is 25 centimeter, 25 centimeter. So for CD, we can write the name AB. Okay. How to establish the formula that I am showing you? See, AB plus AB. In the place of CD, what I will write? AB, AB only, because both of them have same length. Okay, plus DA, DA, DA means BC. Okay, DA, for DA what I will write? BC. Opposite sides of rectangles are equal. Opposite sides of rectangle are equal. So CD, so CD is equal to AB, means CD and AB are equal, and BC and AD are equal. Okay, CD and AB are equal, CD and AB are equal, and BC and AD are equal. Okay, so now see here, how many AB we got? 2 AB we got. See, AB and AB, so what we got? 2 into AB, 2 times AB we got, so 2 into AB, plus how many times BC we got? 2 times BC. So 2 into BC. Okay. So now 2 we can take common to C. 2 common. So 2 into bracket AB plus BC. Okay. So 2 into bracket AB, how much it is given? 25 centimeter. Plus BC, how much it is given? 8 centimeter. Okay, so now let's solve first bracket. 25 plus 8, 33 centimeter, and 33 2s are 66 centimeter. See how this formula we have written, how it established, that I have explained you. You can add directly sides and you can find the perimeter of rectangle, but the formula for perimeter of rectangle, 2 into bracket length plus breadth. So that only we got from this. Perimeter of rectangle is equal to perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into bracket length plus breadth. Okay, we got or not? 2 into bracket, see, 2 into bracket length plus breadth. BC is breadth and see, AB is length. So we got how we establish formula, understood? By this we have established this formula. Perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into bracket length plus breadth. Let's learn now perimeter of regular polygons. Now, a regular polygon is a plane figure. Okay, regular polygon is a plane figure whose all sides and all angles are equal. Okay, regular polygon is a plane figure whose all sides and all angles are equal. Regular polygons are also called regular closed figure. Means what is the example in that? Example, we can take square, square, equilateral triangle. Why square, equilateral triangle? If you will see, square, all sides are equal, all angles are equal. In equilateral triangle, so its all sides and all angles are equal. Means a regular polygon is a plane figure whose all sides and all angles are equal. So this is the example. Okay. So this is the example. Now we learn perimeter of square. Okay, how to find the perimeter of square. Now A, B, C, D is a square. Okay, we'll consider A, B, C, D is a square. Now we have to find the perimeter of square. See, perimeter of a square. Okay, perimeter of square. So sum of lengths of the square. Okay, sum of the lengths of sides of square. Sides of square means what we are going to do? Sum of the lengths of the sides of square. Sum of the lengths of sides of square. See, AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Okay, so AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Okay, so now AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Now see, if you will see in square, all the sides are of equal length. Okay, in square, in a square, all the sides are of equal length. So see, in a square, all the sides are of equal length. All sides are equal. Okay, so what we can write here? AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. Okay, means all sides are equal. CAB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. So perimeter of the square, perimeter of the square is equal to AB plus AB. Now you will say, why not BC? AB plus AB. Now how to establish the formula that I am explaining you? AB plus AB plus AB plus AB. Why? Because all sides are equal. So AB, BC is also, see, BC means if you will see these, all the sides are equal. So means both, all of them have equal measurement. So we'll write AB plus AB plus AB plus AB means in the place of BC also we'll write AB because same sides. So CD also, in the place of CD also we'll write AB, and in the place of DA also we'll write AB. Okay, because all sides are equal. So now how many times AB is given? 4 times. 4 times AB. So 4 into AB. Okay, 4 into AB. Okay, so what we got? 4 into AB means 4 into length of a side. 4 into length of a side. Okay, so what formula we got from this? Perimeter of square is equal to four into side. Or we can say 4 into length of a side. So how we establish this formula? Understood? 4 into side. How we got 4 into side? A. Understood everyone? Let's learn now perimeter of an equilateral triangle. Now what is equilateral triangle? It's all sides are equal and all angles are equal. So now see, this is, we will consider this is equilateral triangle ABC. Okay, so perimeter of the equilateral triangle is equal to sum of the length of sides of the triangle. Okay, sum of the lengths of sides of the triangle. Sides of triangle. Okay, so now which are the sides? Side AB, so AB plus BC plus CA. CA or AC also we can write. Okay, sum of the length of sides of the triangle. Okay, so now in equilateral triangle, these all the sides are equal. So what we can write? AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. All sides are equal. Okay, in equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. Okay, so in an equilateral triangle, all sides are of equal length. Okay, equal length. So AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. Okay, AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. So what we can write? Perimeter of equilateral triangle. Perimeter of equilateral triangle is equal to AB plus, now this side also equal, AB is equal to BC, AB and BC equal length, so AB plus AB, for these also we will write the name AB, okay, because equal length na. For CA also we will write AB. So how many times we got AB? 3 times AB. So 3 into AB. 3 times AB we got. So 3 into AB. So is equal to 3 into length of a side of a triangle. Okay. 3 into side or 3 into length of side. Okay, so what we got the formula? How we generate the formula for this? Perimeter of equilateral triangle is equal to 3 into length of a side. Okay. Let's learn now perimeter of regular pentagon. What is mean by pentagon? Pentagon means it has 5 sides. Okay, and now it is regular pentagon. Means all sides are of equal length. It's all sides are of equal length. Now let's learn to find the perimeter of regular pentagon. So perimeter of regular pentagon is equal to, now AB plus BC. See, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EA. Okay. See, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EA. Okay. Now, see, all sides are of equal length. This is regular pentagon. So in regular pentagon, all sides are of equal length. So what we can write? AB plus AB plus AB plus AB plus AB. Okay, so AB plus AB. Why? Because all sides are of equal length. Now, so here we'll write AB plus, in the place of CD also we'll write AB plus AB plus AB. Okay. Why? Because this measurement and this measurement it is equal. So we have to write AB. This measurement also equal. Means all are equal. So AB plus AB plus AB plus AB plus AB. So how many times AB it is given? 5 times. So 5 into AB. 5 times AB. So 5 into AB. 5 times AB. So 5 into length of one side. Okay. 5 into length of a side. Okay. Length of one side of length of a side. Okay, so what we got the formula for perimeter of regular pentagon, 5 into length of one side. Okay. Let's learn now. Let us practice 13.1. Question number 1. Find the perimeter of the following figures. Now in that second one figure I will explain you. See, this is the second one figure as per your textbook. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to find the perimeter of this given figure. Okay, so perimeter. Okay, so what is perimeter? Perimeter is a distance around a closed figure. What is perimeter? Perimeter is a distance around a closed figure. So now we'll find the perimeter of this figure. See, from here to here, how much it is? 1 centimeter. So we have to add plus, from here to here, 1 centimeter plus, now from here to here, 1 centimeter plus, now see this distance, it is given 1 centimeter. So this is 1 centimeter, so plus 1 centimeter, this is 1 centimeter, so plus 1 centimeter, plus this is 1 centimeter, this is 1 centimeter, plus this is 1 centimeter. Plus, now this distance is 3 centimeter, plus this is 5 centimeter, plus this is 3 centimeter. Okay, so 1 plus 1 2, 2 plus 1 3, plus 1 4, plus 1 5, plus 1 6, plus 1 7, plus 1 8, plus 1 9, 9 plus 3 12, 12 plus 5 17, 17 plus 3 20, so 20 centimeter. So what is the perimeter of this given figure? 20 centimeter. What we have to do in this, we have to add its length. See, this all the length just I have add. Okay, perimeter is the distance around a closed figure. So what is the perimeter of this given figure? 20 centimeter.